In Santa Cruz, a group calling itself the Clean Team is picking up garbage and, even more concerning, used needles off the streets at an alarming rate. Last year alone, these volunteers picked up more than 1,000 needles. With more on the continuing cleanup effort and what the team found today, here's Action News reporter Tom Miller joining us live in Santa Cruz. Tom.
Brittany, these volunteers are people who are typically affected by this. Either they live in impacted neighborhoods like here at Emmeline Avenue, or their children are coming across needles where they're playing. And though this is not a long-term solution, it is helping.
My kids, just, they know about it. They're like, I'll be looking in the grass, like, what are you looking for, needles? Or, you know, my five-year-old's like, look, Mom, there's a needle cap.
Those needle caps and what they cover drove Mariah Campbell to where she is now.
Oh, there's another needle cap.
Giving up her weekends to clean up her neighborhood. Sunday, she found two used needles.
One was right on the sidewalk, and the other one was down by the creek, stuck in to the ground.
She's one of nearly two dozen people volunteering to clean up this creek as part of the Clean Team. Since the group first formed in late 2012, they've picked up more than 1,300 needles and more than 57,000 pounds of trash.
Makes you feel more engrossed, more connected, and like you're doing something about it.
Don Ballesteri and his wife Linda moved here from San Jose in October.
Did you know this is a problem before you moved?
No. No, actually, we were told it was a really quiet, nice neighborhood.
However, they soon discovered drug users hanging out right behind their home.
We want to help out. We want to contribute. We don't want to just complain and, oh, nobody does anything. We wanted to get out here and help out.
One thing the Clean Team can't do anything about is a homeless camp like this where someone set up their sleeping bag, a fishing pole. They have a jacket hanging from the branches. In order for this to be cleaned out, law enforcement needs to post a sign and give whoever lives here 72 hours to get out.
But the goal isn't to kick out homeless people, just to clean up what's left behind. For Campbell, it means a better environment for her family.
It does break my heart. It makes me sad, the reality that my children are growing up in.
The goal that every needle picked up is one unable to cause harm.
And this is not a victimless problem. Six people, including three children, have actually stepped on needles here in Santa Cruz in the last 15 months. As for today's cleanup, five needles were hauled out, along with a whole truckload of trash. Brittany?
Tom, thank you very much. Now, if you would like to volunteer with the Clean Team, you can find their group page on Facebook. It lists when and where they'll be cleaning next.